Hello guys, this is Navin Reddy. So today we'll talk about palindrome number. Now if you talk about any programming language, let it be C, C++ or Java or ASP, you have to deal with number of examples, right? To understand how programming works, you need to go for some examples. So normally we start with even odd, then we go for factorial, then we come across something called as palindrome. Now see, to understand what is palindrome, we have to understand how it works. See, the basic problem is not to code. The problem is what the exact logic to solve that particular problem. And the problem is you have to find a palindrome number. So let's suppose you are given a number. So 1, 2, 3. You have to check the given number is a palindrome or not. Right? Then we have a concept of Armstrong also. So today we'll deal about a palindrome. Now let's suppose you have a number 1, 2, 3. So palindrome simply means you have to reverse this number. So once you get the reverse number, it will be 3 to 1. You have to check both this number are same or not. So 1, 2, 3 should be equal to 3, 2, 1. Right? Now, are they same? No. So we can say they are not palindrome. If you have a number called as 1, 2, 1, and we say if you get a reverse of 1, 2, 1, you will get again 1, 2, 1. So that means this is a palindrome number because our input and outputs are same. So palindrome. Input is different, output is different, not a palindrome, right? So first step we have to go for is reverse. So first you have to reverse a number. So let's go for the logic of reverse. Now to understand how reverse works, think in this way. Let's suppose you have a number again 1, 2, 3. Okay, now once you get this number 1, 2, 3, excuse me, I think we have some word problem. So we have a number 1, 2, 3. Now it's working. Now, if we talk about this number 1, 2, 3, you have to break down these numbers. So first, you have to isolate 3 so that you will get 3. So once you get 3, then you have to increase the status. Like, let's suppose if you have a number 3, so it will be a unit place. So you have to isolate 2 and bring it here. So this 3 should become 30. So you have to multiply this number by 10 so that you can append it with 2. Right? So once you isolate 1, it will come here. Then you have to multiply this number by 10 so that from 32 it becomes 320. So now you will get 321. Right? This is how you have to reverse a number. Okay? So if you go with syntactical way, now let's go for this. So syntactical way, first you require some variables. So let's suppose your variables is int I. Oh, no I. We are fed up with I. Let's suppose n. The number will be 1, 2, 3. Then we require a number called as a variable called as r and s. So initially s will be 0. Now this r we are using for remainders, because to isolate a number we have to find the remainder, then we have to break down the number. So remainder. So once you get the actual reverse will be stored in this s. So to do this we have to apply some steps. So r equal to, it will be n mod 10. Now n mod 10 will give you a remainder. So n is 1, 2, 3. So if you apply mod 10, you will get 3. So here you will get 3. Then you have to actually break down the number. So from 1, 2, 3, you have to make it 1, 2 because already we got 3. So n equal to n divided by 10. Now you will get here n equal to 12. Right? So once you get this 3, you have to increase the status of 3. And that's why you have to multiply this number by 10 and plus r. Initially your s is 0. So 0 into 10 will be 0 plus r, which is 3. Okay. Now you have to do this thing repeatedly for 2, for 1. And that's why we require a while loop. Then question arises, till what time? You have to break down this number, you have to repeat this loop till your n is greater than 0. So once your n becomes 0, you have to stop this process, right? Because once you get n is 0, you are already getting the reverse number, right? So this is how it works. Now, if you want to check, let's go for the actual process. Let's debug this. So your n is 1, 2, 3. N is greater than 0? Yes. Now, n mod 10 will give you 3. So yes, it's your 3. Now, let's suppose we have variables n, r, n, s. Initially, your n is 1, 2, 3. R, n, which is 1, 2, 3, mod 10, you will get r as 3. Right? Now, n equal to n mod 10, it means your n is 1, 2, 3. You have to break down your n. Right? So, your 3 will be removed. You will get only 1, 2. Okay? Because if you talk about n, it's an int value. So, int value only go for the actual question part. Okay? Then after that, you have to go for s equal to s into 10. Now, s is 0 by default. So, 0 into 10 will be 0 plus r. R is your 3, so s becomes 3. Okay? Again, the loop will go on and your n is 1, 2. 1, 12 is greater than 0? Yes. R equal to, it's n. N is 12. 12 mod 10, r will be 2. Right? Then n equal to n mod 10, n is 12, 12 mod 10, 12 divided by 10, you will get 1. Your s is initially 3, so 3, 10. 3 into 10 is 30. 30 plus r, r is your 2, so you will get 3, 2. Okay, so between our sections. Then, again the loop will run because n is 1, so 1 is greater than 0, yes. R equal to n mod 10, you will get r as 1. Right? Then n equal to n divided by 10, n is initially 1, you will get now 0. And once you get here, so s is 32, 32 into 10, it's 320. 320 plus r, which is 1, so we will get 321. So now we have s, which is 321. Again, if we go for the loop, n is 0, 0 is greater than 0, no, and the loop will get out. So if you say loop is out, it means you get a reverse number, which is s. Your initial number was n, but now n is 0. To compare, see, we got the reverse number, right? Now we have to compare what was the input and what is the output. So for the actual go for palindrome, we have to use one more variable called as t, where t equal to n, right? Because n is already 0 here. So once you complete the loop, n will be 0. We don't want n will be 0. We want initial value, so it will be stored in t. So now we can say here, if your t is equal to s, okay, so if your t is equal to s, it means your number is palindrome because your input and output is same. So we have to go for SOP. Again, SOP is system.out.println. Language changes, statement changes, everything is same. In C you write printf, in C out, in C++ you write C out. In Java you have to go for system.out.println. And in brackets, you have to say it's palindrome. Right? Or otherwise, if you say else part, else you have to say SOP, not a palindrome. Okay? So either it can be a palindrome or not a palindrome. So if your input and outputs are same, palindrome. If your input is different from output, not a palindrome. You have to reverse a number. First step, you have to reverse a number. To reverse a number, we have this logic. So if you're finding a number reverse, so you can apply this logic. But if you have to go for palindrome, first you have to reverse, then you have to check your initial point and your ending part, which is your s. If they are same, palindrome. If you are different, not a palindrome. Now if you can check for any number, let it be 1 to 1. So if you go for 1 to 1 initially, now this whole thing changes. Ultimately, the reverse number you will get is 1 to 1. If your input is 1 to 1, your output will be 1 to 1 because if you go for all this processing, 1 to 1 is equal to 1 to 1, yes, we get a palindrome. For 1 to 3, not a palindrome. For 1 to 1, palindrome. So it means 1 to 1 is a palindrome. 1 to 3 is not a palindrome. Right? Simple, right? Again, if you want the actual code, find below in description area, you will find the actual link for the code. And for further videos, please subscribe. Thank you so much.